Hello friends, this presentation is a part of an NME ICT project sponsored by MHRD Government of India. Our today's topic of discussion is ethanol fermentation. As by fermentation we are going to produce ethanol on large scale, first we must understand uses of alcohol. There are various uses of alcohol, such as ethanol is used as an organic solvent in variety of products. The most popular use of ethanol is as motor fuel and fuel additive like gasohol. Ethanol is used as a potent food preservative at home. Ethanol is used as the fluid in thermometers. It is used in making antiseptic soap and cosmetics as it is having antimicrobial and antifungal activities. Ethanol is routinely consumed in different forms around the world like beer, wine, gin, whiskey, etc. Ethanol plays an important role in making drugs and pharmaceuticals. Ethanol is again used in the preparation of essence and flavorings. It is renewable in nature, which is useful for fueling clean, environmental friendly compartments. Ethanol is also used in preserving biological specimens. In 1906, when the Industrial Alcohol Act was passed, the production of industrial alcohol, that is ethanol, became commercially feasible on a large scale. This act allowed the sale of tax-free alcohol if alcohol has first denatured to avoid its use in various alcohol beverages. But as it is a type of microbial product, biochemical process should be there behind production of ethanol. It is a biological process in which sugars are utilized to produce ethanol and carbon dioxide as metabolic waste products. This process is a complicated sequence of transformations carried out by yeast cells that converts glucose to carbon dioxide and alcohol. Before fermentation, one glucose molecule is converted into two pyruvate molecules by glycolysis. And as we all know, glycolysis is the first level of aerobic respiration. Most species of yeast will produce ethanol only under anaerobic condition. So, ethanol fermentation is classified as an anaerobic process. However, many yeast such as Saccharomyces cerevisiae as well as Schizosaccharomyces pombei will produce ethanol even under aerobic conditions. Now, to establish fermentation industry, our first necessity is fermentation strain. As fermentation microorganisms, all yeast are not suitable. Choice of yeast for the alcohol production depends upon the composition of the medium, particularly the type of carbohydrate used in the medium. So here one table is given which shows various raw materials used in medium with specific strain of yeast. Whenever starch and sugar are utilized as raw material, Saccharomyces cerevisiae will be utilized as fermentation strain. But in the presence of lactose of whey, Candida pseudotropicalis is utilized, and whenever sulfur waste liquor will be there as a raw material, Candida utilis is useful. Fermentation strain should contain several properties like they must grow rapidly, they should tolerate high concentrations of sugar, they must be able to produce abundant amounts of alcohol, they must be resistant to the produced higher concentration of alcohol. This process is used in the production of alcoholic beverages, ethanol fuel, as well as in the rising of bread dough. Fermentation media. The media for the commercial production includes blackstrap molasses or corn, potatoes, grains, wood waste, sulfite waste liquor, whey, etc. For the molasses fermentation, to keep final sugar concentration between 10 to 18% because concentration greater than 20% are detrimental to yeast. The pH of the medium is set between 4.8 to 5. Some starchy media like corn, rye, and barley can be utilized, but initial starch hydrolysis is necessary. This can be done by squashing with barley malt, by mixing with dilute acids, or by utilizing amylolytic enzymes of fungi like Aspergillus and Rhizopus. When ethanol fermentation is going on in large reactors, temperature should be kept between 21 to 27 degrees centigrade. But as heat gets evolved, it raises the temperature up to 30 degrees centigrade, which bring down by cooling coils. Fermentation continues for 2 to 3 days, but exact time period is based on the substrate utilized and temperature. At the end, fermentation broth contains 6 to 9% alcohol by volume. This alcohol yield reflects 90 to 98% theoretical conversion of substrate sugar to alcohol. So yields should not be confused with proof, as proofing means alcohol concentration designation, and it will be twice the percentage in volume of ethanol as dissolved in water. For example, 70% ethanol is 140 proof. Last most important stage is recovery of product. Ethanol is separated from fermentation broth in continuous stills. Ethanol of 95% concentration is obtained by successive distillations. To obtain 100% or absolute alcohol, special distillation technique is required. For that, 5% water is removed by forming an azeotropic mixture of benzene, water, and ethanol, which then is distilled with increasing temperature. This procedure removes first the azeotropic benzene ethanol water mixture and then benzene ethanol mixture so that absolute ethanol remains. So by that we have completed discussion of each and every parameter of alcohol fermentation. Thank you.